Yes. God is a good God. Amen. God is a good God. Yes, he is. Amen, amen, and amen. We're going to invite you to your scripture and your prayer for this morning. We're going to have Evangelist Denise Moore and Elder Terry Moore. They're going to come in that order and give us our scripture and our prayer for this morning. Let us keep our ears open, because this might just be when God will drop a word of knowledge in your hearing.
Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Those praisers, they just sung two of my favorite things. I love to praise him. And God, I love to praise him. I love to praise him. I love to praise him. He's worthy. He's worthy. I love to praise him. I'll be coming out of 1 John 4 and 11. 1 John 4 and 11. When you have it, say amen. God is good. God is good. God is good. And I love him. I love to praise him. Amen. 1 John 4 and 11. Beloved, if God so love us, we ought also to love one another. No man has seen God at any time. If we love one another, God dwells in us. If his love is perfect in us, hereby know we that we dwell in him and he in us, because he has given us his spirit. His spirit. Nobody else's spirit, but God's spirit. And we have seen and do testify that the Father sent the Son to be the Savior of the world. Not to some parts of the world, but all the world. Whosoever shall confess that Jesus is the Son of God, God dwells in him, and he in God. And we have known and believed the love that God has to us. God is love, and he that dwells in love dwells in God, and God in him. Herein is our love made perfect, that we may have boldness in the day of judgment. Because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love, but perfect love casts out fear, because fear has torment. He that fear is not made perfect in love. We love him because he first loved us. If a man say, I love God, and hates his brother, he's a liar. For he that love not his brother whom he has seen, how can he love God who he has not seen? And this commandment have we from him. This is a commandment. This is not nothing I'm telling you, bishop tell you, no other preacher tell you. It's a commandment that we love God, that he who loves God love his brother also. We supposed to love each other. That's what makes the world go round. It's love. So you better listen, because it is a commandment. May the Lord add a blessing to the reading of his word.
Praise the Lord, church. This is a promising time. You know, I'm a person, according to the word, God is everywhere. God is a God. He sits high and he looks low. He looks down on the inward parts of man. He knows your thoughts from afar off. Usually we'll say, if you have any prayer requests, make them known. But God already knows. So you don't have to say anything out loud. If you're saying it within yourself, God hear you. And I believe that he hear you. And I believe that if you cry out to God with your whole heart, then he'll honor them requests. This is a time of consecration here going on in the church. It's a time where you take that defiled body and self and mind of yours, and it's a time to get it right. It's a time to believe that God is God, and he still reigns. He loves his people. He loves you, and you need to understand and know that. So we're going to bow our heads, if we just join hands with the person beside you. and let's join hands and go to the throne of grace. Heavenly Father, we come. Lord, we come because you have given us the right, Lord, to come freely to the throne of grace. Oh, Lord, to ask anything that we desire of thee. Lord, you said that if we come believing, oh, Lord, that you are, Lord, that we will receive it. Right now, I know that you're God and you're God all by yourself. I know that you're God that sits high and you look low. I know that you look on the inward parts of man. Lord, your word declared that you know our thoughts from afar off. So, Lord, we don't have to shout out loud or speak anything because, Lord, you're reading our thoughts and you're reading our minds. Lord, the word said it is you that created us and not we ourselves. Lord, you know all about your creation. Lord, you have power over all that you created. Lord, we realize and we understand today, Lord, that if it had not been for you, Lord, we wouldn't be here right now. If it had not been for you, Lord, we wouldn't have woke up this morning. Lord, we wouldn't have been able to clothe ourselves, been in our right minds. Lord, this morning, we just want to thank you. Thank you for all that we're going through. Oh, Lord, thank you for the suffering. Oh, Lord, thank you for the joy. Thank you for your peace. Thank you, oh, Lord, for the hope that's down in us. This morning, Lord, we come in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, just to call on your holy name, Lord, because we know and believe that there is power in the name of Jesus. Lord, this morning, as we humbly bow before you, oh, Lord, we just want to thank you, oh, Lord, for your precious blood. Oh, Lord, the words say, what can wash away my sins? Nothing but the blood of Jesus. Lord, we believe that there is power in the blood of Jesus. Lord, we come for no reason of our own, Lord, but to give you the praise, to give you the worship, to give you the glory. Lord, we pray that you will free us, that you will release us, oh Lord. Oh Lord, that we might magnify your name. For Lord, you said if I be lifted up above all the earth, Lord, that you would draw men unto you. Lord, somebody in here this morning don't know you in the free pardon of their sins. Somebody in here needs saved. Somebody need a healing. Somebody need deliverance. Oh Lord, somebody need encouragement. Lord, somebody needs you in here this morning. Lord, for we all need you, but some need you more than most. Lord, we come this morning in your most holy and excellent name, saying, come, Jesus, come. Oh, Lord, come free the captive. Break the chains, oh, Lord, loose the shackles. Oh, Lord, and let them come running, saying, what must I do to be saved? Save them, Jesus, save them. Not only save them, Lord, but, Lord, let them cry out, I want to be baptized. I want to be baptized by the water and by the Spirit. Oh, Lord, we come to praise you, Lord. We come to lift you up, Lord. We come to exalt your name, oh, Lord. We come to show a cruel, cruel world that our Lord liveth. And I know he liveth, oh, Lord, because the reaction of his life is in us. Lord, we know that he lives in us. Lord, this morning, Lord, bless the pastor. Give him a word. Give him a word, oh, Lord. We came, Lord. We need to hear a word. We need to hear from you, Jesus. Lord, tell us, oh, Lord, what we ought to do, what we should be doing, how we ought to live. Oh, Lord, help us, oh, Lord, so when the day comes when we step from this side of the earth realm into glory, Lord, we can hear you say, well done, thy good and faithful servant. Come on up a little higher and let me make you ruler over many. Not because you've been perfect, but because you've been faithful over a few things. Lord, let us be faithful and perfect in our love towards you and towards one another. For this, Lord, we give you all praise, glory, and honor. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Jesus.